everybody. Welcome to this week's edition of Gone Viral, your weekly infotainment message for all things related to Loewen's physical and health education class. This week's focus is on mental health. You might have seen what I did, which is that when this whole pandemic thing started, I'm not convinced people were like really in their right minds sort of with the things that they were doing.
It seems like we kind of got two things going on here. We got the COVID crisis, and then we've got like the toilet paper famine. Now, I don't really understand the whole idea of the toilet paper famine. So I decided to go look back and check out some of the my favorite movies that deal with a virus. Now, they also probably deal with zombies, which isn't really what's going on with this, although some would argue. That a zombie virus would actually be quite a bit more fun than whatever it is that we're going through right now. I just took a look through these videos just to see kind of, you know, what do people do when they're faced with a pandemic? Like, bam, wow, okay, it's a pandemic. We're going to have to do something. What are we going to do? Apparently in Canada, what we do is we go out and we buy as much toilet paper as we can. Now, I'm not sure why this is. Is this because we're so full of crap? Maybe, not sure. But I'll tell you right now, you take a look at the movies, that's not what they do. So, for example, one of my favorite TV shows, Walking Dead, you'll notice that when Rick gets up, no, he's not looking for toilet paper. Okay, what's he doing? Geez, here I am, I've woken up, there's nobody around. I'm probably gonna get a drink of water and figure out what's going on. 28 days later, same idea. Guy wakes up in a hospital, he starts looking to find out what's happening. He's not breaking into stores and grabbing as much toilet paper as he can. No, he's trying to figure out what the heck is going on. One of my favorites from the movie Resident Evil. Alice wakes up, you know, she's not thinking, geez, how do I deal with that with a number two here? Where is my paper? No, again, she's getting herself situated, trying to figure out what the heck just happened to her. Now, contagion. Here's a direct example. You got a bunch of people freaked out and running around because they got this virus thing happening. They're getting things like bottled water, dry goods, batteries, flashlights. I mean, these are all positive things to have around just in case there's a break in the supply chain. You'll notice there isn't a single person in there. Nobody is slamming as much toilet paper into their cart as they possibly can. Let's say we did run out of toilet paper. I mean, there's some options. Number one, most bathrooms also have a shower in them as well. So perhaps we could take care of our business and then hop into the shower right away. Pretty easy solution. Number two, get yourself a big old leaf. I mean, what do you think toilet paper is made of? It's made up of trees. How bad can leaves be? Stay away from the bark though. Trust me, from personal experience, it doesn't work as well. The next possibility is a rag. I don't really want to go into too much detail on that one. But I mean, come on, man, these things are naturally reusable. Really, the simplest solution would be the following. You'll notice that in all those stores where the toilet paper aisles are completely empty, right beside them, you've got full aisles full of paper towel. And you might think, well, you're not supposed to flush paper towel. Okay, putting in the garbage, yeah, I can understand, might be some issues that way. But then what about the boxes and boxes and boxes of Kleenex? Which is basically just toilet paper in squares, or rectangles, I guess. What's wrong with them? Why are those all on the shelf but the toilet paper's all gone?
Oh, gee, I never thought of it like that.
That is a mystery that I have no explanation for.
So before you get the wrong idea, don't think that I'm saying that mental health is a joke. It is not. Your mental health is incredibly important. Also important is the ability to have a sense of humor, a sense of resiliency, and the ability to, you know, not to take yourself too seriously. This week's assignment is going to have you exploring the issues of mental health and how they're connected to our exercise. I'm really looking forward to seeing what you guys come up with. Well, that's it. We will see you next week somewhere on the interweb. And until then, remember,
stay safe, stay active, stay connected. Till next time, peace out. I'm the voodoo child.